like there will be a continuous wavelength, like our human brain. So the brain can be changeable, it can be very fragile, we cannot predict on that. So what I'm trying to do is, there is three patterns of deep sleep, sleep and awake. From that, let's say the person is started to sleep around 10 o'clock, and then he is around in the deep sleep around 11 to 2 o'clock. Let's say this is one pattern. And from this pattern, we can see, we can figure it out using simple hypothesis testing or any kind of null hypothesis testing. That can be really helpful. We can find the min max values of each individual graphs. And from this graph, we can figure it out what is the pattern in it. According to the MIT professor Dr. Pat, he explained, if there is a uphill kind of, I don't figure it out the actual word for this, but it's like if there is a peak value of any graph, then we can say it like the person is awake. And this awake state is like, we have nothing to do with the awake state. But if the person is sleeping and again he's kind of woke up or doing something, then that must be some problem, because that may hamper to the good sleep. So my question is here, we have the continuous data and we are trying to figure it out, the chunk of data. So what I did, find the lowest state. Please prepare to leave. The lowest state, when while calculating the lowest state of sleep pattern of the data, I simply did the derivative of that chunk of the data. Let's say I have taken this to this part and simple derivative of with respect to x-axis, which is the time. And then what we are trying to figure it out, we are converting that data to an image state. The image state can be x-dash, y-dash of different grayscale or RGB, whichever you prefer to figure it out. But it can be really helpful because we are converting the continuous data and chunk it in different pattern, and then we are converting to the image state. So that can be really helpful. I hope I try to explain a little bit, or maybe I just grab up so fast. I will try to explain more, but the sum of this video is like, we can figure it out the pattern in a continuous data using simple derivatives, the mathematical application, and we can convert them into gray image or color image. That can be helpful to your project. I'll come up with other more explanations. So till then, I'll see what I can do with this data. I hope this is useful. Maybe I need to explain a little bit more. I'll try my best. Anyway, thank you so much for watching it. Thank you. Bye-bye.